What's going on, everybody? This episode, we're going to be talking about environment files or environment variables. These are often defined in a hidden file on your local machine. So these are something you're not going to check into version control. So you're not going to put it in Git, and you're not going to share this file with other people. It's going to contain information that's just used for you. Now, oftentimes, the values will be very similar for other people, or maybe even the same. So oftentimes default values will be used in the code, and then we have the ability to overwrite those values using local values if we choose to. A very common example of what I just described is with the port used for the server. By default, it's 3000, but we have the ability to give a custom port if we want to use 3000 for something else. We could use 3001 or whatever it might be. So we're going to learn how to create an environment file for our port choice, as well as our MongoDB connection string. The first major change you want to make in your code, instead of assigning a value to port directly, you have the ability to get this from an environment file. So this will usually look like process.env.port or 3000 if that is undefined. So this is a very common setup that you will see. Now, down here where we start our server, at the bottom here where it says app.listen port, we say app listening on port, and then display that value. So if we provide a different value, we should see that in the console, as well as be able to access the site from a different URL. Now, this video is sponsored by FileStack, so if you want to support this channel, check out the link down below. This is a tool for image processing and file processing, so if you want your app to easily be able to work with files and images, FileStack is going to give you a lot of different tools to make that possible. For example, automatic document conversion, as well as converting between some of the most common file types. So whether that's spreadsheets, Word documents, presentations, or graphics files. There's a lot of powerful things you can do with FileStack, so definitely would appreciate you checking out the link below. Now, I want to talk about, before we go in and create an environment file, there's an alternative way to provide values for the environment. So when you run your server, the way we've been running it is if you check out the package.json, we have this start command, which is npx nodemon. You may occasionally see people start the server differently where they provide a value for something. So for example, port is equal to 3001, and then they'll say npx nodemon, and this works in a very similar way. Looks like we're having an authentication failed, but that's just MongoDB, so let me go back and actually update that username and password. And you can see app listening on port 3001. What that means is for our calls, we actually need to change this port. And now it'll work on 3001. And you can see it's still working. This value can actually be passed through using npm run start. So for example, if we issue the previous command we just issued, port 3001, and just said npm run start, this port is going to still work. So you might see that as well. And there you go, app listening on port 3001. So basically what this is doing is it's getting that value first and realizes there is no need for the default 3000. You could, of course, do the same idea for the connection string. So you could say const connection or con or whatever, and then get this from process.env.con. But I don't think it'd be very convenient to have to pass that in the terminal every single time you run the application. So we're going to talk about a different way to do this, so we can just do it one time, and that is with an environment file. So if you take a look at your project, and we'll go back to the root of our project and we'll create a new file. So just right click anywhere and say new file. This is going to be called .env, so it's a hidden file. And this is where the environment variables are going to be read from by default. So let's go ahead and open that file, and we will try to define one here, such as the port. And the syntax for this is just like we did inside of the terminal, so we'll just say port is equal to some value. Let's go with a different number just to be sure that this is actually being read from this file. So we will save this. However, this is not going to work by default. What that means is if we close out of our running server and we relaunch this time just using npm run start, without passing in the port, it's not just going to magically get this port from the env file. You can see it still says port 3000 down here. We need to do one more thing. So what we'll do is we will close out of this, and we actually need to tell it how to get the port from the environment file. So we'll say npm install, and we're going to use a dependency called .env, And this is how we're going to read from this file. All right, so that package is installed. Now what you can do is inside of app.js, you can require that package and use the config method to retrieve values. So we will do that here after these other two requires. So we'll say const .env, for example, and we'll say require passing in .env. Now you can say .env.config. Now we'll say npm run start, and you can see it now says listening on port 3005. So that's all you have to do to have it automatically read from the environment file. Now there's a few other ways you might see this setup. A common setup is if you only want it to read from the environment file if you're not in production, you can basically create an if statement for that structure. So let's talk about how we can do that. Where you do this is probably not a big deal. I'm going to do it down here before we grab the port, and we'll say if, and then I'll just define that structure real quick, process.env.nodeenv is not equal to production. So if we don't flag our npm run start with node environment being equal to production, then we will read from the .env file with .env.config, and then we will remove this line up here so we don't just do it all the time. So let's see if this works the way we expect. Let's go ahead and just restart the server just to make sure we are solid. npm run start, and you can see it says app listening on port 3005. If you wanted to change that and say, hey, this is now in production, what you would do is just say node env is equal to production, and then npm run start. And now it says app listening on port 3000. You'll often see this shortened too, just by doing the require at the same time, which, you know, you can be very dynamic with this. So we'll say require then dot on that. This will replace the need for the .env here actually. So it'll just say require .env.config. And now we can remove this line altogether. Now, just to be sure I'm not crazy, we will issue another npm run start and see that we were able to get the app running on 3005. Now, we could do something very similar for the connection string. So to say const connection is coming from process.env.connection, and we will use this instead of the hard-coded value down below. Now, you could pass this through the terminal or within the environment file, which is most likely what you're going to be doing. So we would just cut this connection string out of here, remove that, and we'll also remove those quotes there and just replace it with connection. Now we'll take the new connection string value and place it inside of the environment. So paste. Now you don't need quotes here, so this is what it's going to look like. We'll save, make sure that is saved and app.js is saved so that it's actually getting the new changes, and that you can confirm things are working. So what we'll do is we'll just restart npm run start, and it appears to be working as it once did. But now we don't have our connection string in our code.
Now there's one more very important thing you need to do, and that is add your environment file to your gitignore so you don't check it into version control and expose those values to the internet. Most likely if you've used a gitignore template like I did, that'll already be in here. So if I search .env, you can see that here. So what that means is if I say git status, you're not going to see anything about a .env file. It should not show up in your repo at all. That means you will need some setup instructions. You will need to make sure you know to set these up when you clone this repo in the future. So you might need to, instead of having a .env file, have a .env example file with some fake values here. That is then something you could check into version control and people could see so they know what they need to set up. They could then just rename it to .env, change the values, and they're good to go. That's all I got in this video. Stay tuned for the next video where we're actually going to start working with MongoDB schemas inside of our code. So stay tuned and be sure to subscribe.